All right, good morning, everyone, and welcome to WHIT Radio's The Morning Buzz. I'm your host, Michael, and I'm joined by Bria. Good morning, Bria. How are you?
I'm good, and you?
Cold.
Same.
Very
here.
Cold. Very cold. In the news today, we have some college athletes play like adults but read like fifth graders. We'll also have some information coming for you about the whole Dennis Rodman meltdown. We'll talk about that. But first, let's talk about these college athletes. Early in her career as a learning specialist, Mary Willingham was in her office when a basketball player at the University of North Carolina walked in looking for help with his classwork. He couldn't read or write, and I kind of panicked. "What do you do with that?" she said, recalling the meeting. Willingham's job was to help athletes who aren't quite ready academically for the work required at UNC at Chapel Hill, one of the country's top public universities. But she was shocked that one couldn't read, and then she found he was not an anomaly. Soon she'd meet a student athlete who couldn't read multisyllabic words. She had to teach him to sound out Wisconsin, as kids do in elementary school. And then another came with this request: if I could teach him to read well enough so he could read about himself in the news, because that was something really important to him, Willingham said. Student athletes who couldn't read well but played in the money-making collegiate sports of football and basketball are not a new phenomenon, and they certainly aren't found only at UNC Chapel. A CNN investigation found public universities across the country where many students in the basketball and football programs could read only up to an eighth grade level. The data obtained through open records requests also showed a staggering achievement gap between college athletes and their peers at the same intuition. So obviously a very alarming story. A lot of these college athletes can't read. And I think one of the main problems is they're set up to go through life so they don't need to read. They're making all of these all this money in these physically demanding activities that academically there's just no need for it because they're so set. You know what
well,
I mean?
Well, they get into the colleges and they get scholarships.
Right.
But they're not set career-wise unless they go to
the NFL. You're right, Mr.
So, hey, the colleges are doing great. Right. They're packing the stadiums.
Right.
The kid's getting free scholarship, but he doesn't graduate from college.
Right.
He has no real skills. And if he doesn't get in the NFL, where does he go?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
The problem is they're able to get into these colleges while not being able to read, and that, you know, puts into their mind that, you know, maybe someone else and my athletic ability and my talent will get me somewhere else where I can, again, void the reading dilemma.
Right.
Very scary. Very scary. Bria, mm-hmm. So Dennis Rodman made headlines again. He melted down during some interview. Tell us about that.
Eccentric basketball star Dennis Rodman's bizarre outburst about an American citizen jailed in North Korea has drawn widespread criticism, including from the prisoner's family. Rodman is in North Korea with other former NBA players for a basketball game against a local team that's due to take place Wednesday, the birthday of the country's leader Kim Jong-un. Rodman, 52, who visited North Korea three times previously in the past year, describes Kim as a beloved friend, shrugging off the heavily criticized human rights record.
Wow.
Yeah.
Jeez. Okay. So, Rodman's in the headlines again.
Mixed bag there because he's our only ambassador to North Korea. So,
yeah.
as bad as that is, he's our only connection, and it's a rogue nation.
But
yeah.
I have a hard time. Well, this is kind of a rogue man. He was always kind of out there.
Wasn't he on that show with the rehab?
I'm sure he was. I'm not sure. I know
that's that guy who does that show in VH1, MTV, some show, and it he's
right.
A doctor, and he has a celebrity rehab. It's a celebrity rehab show.
He might be, to
yeah.
be honest. I mean, he made a cameo appearance, and I think this is very appropriate, in Men in Black as an alien. I don't think any of us would really doubt that if we found out. I mean, the guy, he was a great player.
Yeah.
He always looked nuts. We saw this little meltdown he had the other day. He kind of seems nuts. And it is scary that he is our one connection to North Korea there, a man like this. To be honest, I don't buy that they're actually friends, that Dennis Rodman is really going over there to.
Well, he's a big basketball fan, Kim.
Yes.
And he was a big Chicago Bulls fan. So,
yes, yes.
So there is a connection. Whether they're great friends, good friends, who cares, really? But there's a connection, and it's better to have some dialogue with this guy than no dialogue. So that's my feeling.
I was thinking, on the world stage, in the public eye, we must look pretty funny. Dennis Rodman being our only connection to North Korea, they must be looking at us like, are you serious? This guy who has these piercings, and I mean, the guy does look kind of crazy. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, we must look pretty funny. It's a great publicity stunt. I mean, for Dennis, it's certainly ways to make headlines. Kudos to that, Dennis. This day in history, back in 2011, on January 8th, it was a sad day. Arizona Representative Gabrielle Gifford was among 17 shot by a gunman at a meeting outside a grocery store. Six people were fatally wounded, including United States District Court Judge John Roll and a young girl. Police identified the gunman as Jared Lee Loughner. But that was a sad day in history. We all remember that. That was not too long ago, and the fight for gun control still goes on. We've been having some frigid temperatures.
For us, it's crazy.
Frigid temperatures. Bria.
Yesterday, it was 5 degrees.
Mm-hmm.
5 degrees.
And
oh
the
my,
real
I
feel...
I couldn't feel my face. When I walked outside, I think it was mostly the wind. Because,
mm-hmm.
oh my goodness, I couldn't feel it. My hands were numb.
The high yesterday was 20, which we really didn't see.
No, I didn't think we hit that.
No. And the low was 4.
We certainly felt that.
The real feel was definitely, I thought, 12 below.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, there was gusts up to 25 miles per hour yesterday. It was windy. It was just a perfect storm. And we're not used to this kind of weather. It was almost record-breaking.
Well, do you know the all-time lowest temperature ever recorded in New Jersey?
30 below?
Close.
Huh?
37 below.
37
in
below.
Rivervale, New Jersey.
Wow.
In January, sometime in January.
Wow.
And states that you do not think would ever have temperatures like this, Alabama had a temperature of minus 25 about 100 years ago, and Florida had a minus 2.
Oh
so,
goodness.
You know, these temperatures happen.
Wacky weather. It's really not any warmer out right now. It's 12 degrees out right now. The real feel is minus 1.
Yeah.
It'll go up to 25, though, so
yeah, tomorrow,
get out the shorts.
And the rest of the week, we'll see progression.
Yeah, rest of the week, it looks dry. Which is good.
It looks like it's going to be on and off with rain, too.
Well, Saturday and Sunday.
Yeah.
But the good thing with that is it's coming at the perfect time because Saturday is going to be 56 degrees.
Yeah.
This weather is crazy. I swear it's global warming. People need to stop littering. Seriously, it's getting crazy. And I'm used to the weather being, like, just chill.
You know? And
you know? And like,
this,
not crazy and wacky, you
this
know?
This is unusually, unseasonably cold for January. You know... Early January.
Yeah.
We're used to this in February, early March. This is ridiculous. It's only going to get colder.
And it's a term I've never heard before, polar vortex.
Polar
never
vortex.
Heard that
I've never heard
term
that
before.
One either,
polar
but they're throwing
vortex?
It around.
Yeah,
it's
a new term.
Sounds like something out of a sci-fi movie. It's really kind of unusual.
Wait, does that mean something like polar, like bipolar, like the weather's changing a lot?
Well,
polar,
it was just a term
polar,
to describe...
up north.
Yeah.
The pole
like the polar air, cold air. It was just a term used by weather people this past week to describe the widespread cold that the country has seen. But like I said, Saturday's going to be 56, Sunday's going to be 54, so... you know, crack out the sunscreen, some shorts.
Crack out no sunscreen. We're just lucky to have
decent weather. A lot of people are going to get sick, I'm telling you. Well, with the change like that. So be prepared. Guys, today, stay bundled up. Watch for ice when you're driving. Watch black ice when you're walking. Watch ice, guys. It's dangerous out there. Stay warm. That'll do it for today's show. Thank you, everyone, for tuning in to WHIT Radio's The Morning in Buzz. I was your host, Michael. We were joined by Bruce. See you next time.
And I was in it.